Sahan is a Somali word that means pioneer. So we are trying to pioneer a new way of storytelling when it comes to immigrant communities in Minnesota.
That is what Mukhtar Ibrahim told me years ago when he was launching the news website, the Sahan Journal. He had a singular goal and dream. He alluded to just there. Tell the stories of immigrants in Minnesota with the depth and nuance they weren't getting from long-standing media outlets, including this one. It became Sahan Journal. For far more than a dream come true, it's now a critical news outlet in our state, from a scrappy startup to the real deal, with a different voice than anyone else in the media game. And as it has succeeded, it will soon be looking for a successor to Mukhtar. Here's Sharon with the reason why.
Talk to me about when you first started Sahan. Just some of the emotions when you first started.
I had no experience in business or fundraising or building projects or managing people. But when you're so passionate about something that, you know, you're not scared, you just dive in and see where it takes you. And I really dived in. It was all consuming.
Why are you stepping down?
The organization is very strong. We have good funding. We have, as I mentioned, good, healthy organizational culture. The more we can provide that space for people who don't usually get that opportunity to lead, is something that I'm really excited to do and step aside. So the second part of why I'm stepping down is I am a father of four young children. I just want to have, I don't want to lose that window I have before they, you know, grow up.
Can you kind of expand upon that? What kind of gap you were trying to fill with the creation of Sahan Journal?
We don't often cover the stories of immigrants and communities of color in a more nuanced, rich way that brings the full breadth of, you know, the humanity. We tend to focus on a slice. A reporter should be establishing deep connections and trust in communities that they cover. Reporters in mainstream newsrooms need to rethink and reimagine how they cover people. And especially, you know, our white peers need to feel comfortable and step out of their comfort zone and be in the communities and establish that connections that any reporter should be doing. You know, I'm not in a rush. I want to see how this search unfolds, and the transition and making sure everything is running smoothly is a big part for me. So after that happens, after we bring in and onboard a new leader, we'll see what's next for me.
So Mukhtar will stay on board with Sahan until his replacement is selected by the board, but he says he hopes he can lift someone else up into a position that has great influence over how the news gets covered in the state of Minnesota. Quite a run. Thanks so much, Mukhtar.